Okay, we're into the Module 4 lab activity, and if you've clicked on the proper link, you should wind up at this Lunar Phases lab, and I can't encourage you enough to go through all the background material. Part of the very beginning of the student guide does involve some of this background material, but it's really crucial, you know, in addition to your reading in the textbook, to understand these moon phases. And if you remember, you know, you may have to backtrack a little bit in the book to go back to where moon phases were discussed. I believe it was chapter 3. But this first background page shows you the different shapes of the moon phases. In fact, background page 2 gets a little more, breaks them down even more. Not only showing you the different shapes, but also the necessary orientation, where the moon must be with respect to the sun and the earth in order to get these different shapes. So, you know, really put yourself in the mind of being on the earth there, and seeing how you get these different shapes from those orientations. And a couple of the other background pages will help you even more in that effort. For example, this background page 3. This allows you to move your little guy around and notice the different times of day. So again, can't encourage you enough to really visualize yourself standing on the earth and realizing, do you see the sun or not from your location? Sure enough, this guy, notice he's starting to see the sun. His left arm, if he's facing away from us, is pointed toward the sun. And his right arm is pointed toward the blackness of space. That's daytime. It's sunrise. He's just starting to see the sun. Now the sun is high in his sky. He's at noontime. And now the sun is setting for him. His right arm, if he's facing away from us, is pointed toward the sun. His left arm is pointed toward space. So the sun is setting, and now it's nighttime. He can't see the sun from where he's at. That's midnight. Okay, so get used to orienting yourself and understanding that, yes, as the Earth rotates, you'll either see the sun or you won't see the sun. You'll either be on the daytime side of the Earth or you'll be on the nighttime side of the Earth. Okay, so that background page 3 helps you understand that. Background page 4 has another really cool simulator, which, you know, my preference is to use the rotate sky instead of observer option, and then just animate this. This is very similar to the lunar phase dial. If you made a lunar phase dial, that's essentially what you created. You created a horizon piece, and you created the rest of the sky. And so again, as the Earth rotates, all the stars, as well as the sun, as well as the moon, appear to move from east to west in our sky. Okay, so that's background page 4. Background page 5 is a way of tying together the moon phases with our solar motion demonstrator, or the motions of the sun simulator we've used before. So notice that in this particular setup, it's kind of a moon phase dial. Notice the sun is high in the sky, high in the southern sky. This would be noontime, right, when the sun is high in the sky. Notice that the moon is just starting to rise. So you can ask yourself, what moon phase is that? Certainly it would be a quarter phase. I'll let you guys figure out which moon phase that might be. But that was background page 5. Background page 6 is Witness and Detective, worth checking out. Let's move on to the bisectors, moon bisector demo. Now, in addition to knowing having to know the orientation, as far as how to get the phases out of the orientation, this is very, very useful. Again, you just start clicking on step by step. You show the sun direction. Okay, the sun is over on the left side of the screen. The sun bisectors. This means if the sun is over on the left side, part of the moon will be illuminated, part of the earth will be illuminated. And it turns out to be the left sides. And so you can see the shadows. So when you click on the shadows, that shows, okay, this side of the moon is illuminated by the sun, this side is not. Likewise with the earth. Here's the daytime side, here's the nighttime side. Now, to figure out what the phase is going to look like, you show the line that connects the Earth and the Moon, as well as the bisectors there. If you're on the Earth, the side that's facing the Moon will be able to see the Moon, but not see the entire Moon. It'll only see the side of the Moon that's facing the Earth. So it turns out that if you are on this side of the Earth, you'll be able to see the Moon. But what do you see when you look at that Moon? You see the right side is dark. You see the left side is being lit up. So what phase is that? Third quarter moon. Okay, so I encourage you to play around with this moon phase, the moon bisector demo. will really come in handy in helping you understand how the different moon phase shapes come about. And it's all because of how much of the moon you're able to see from the Earth. Likewise, and what you'll use the most then is the lunar phase simulator. This is the thing that will help you get the lab activity done and the student guide done. And so it's a combination of the moon phase thing that we saw earlier, as well as the solar motion demonstrator. It shows, okay, as I move my guy around here, notice that, okay, we said it was sunset, right? Well, notice that our guy sit on the Earth there. The moon is in his, or the sun is in his western sky. So that is the sun is setting. And I notice as we move him on toward midnight, he's on the nighttime side of the Earth. And sure enough, where's the sun with respect to him? It's below the horizon. Now the sun rises. And sure enough, there he is. Now, you might ask, well, where's the moon? Well, it turns out that the moon is in new moon phase, so it is essentially lined up with the sun. We don't really see the moon here. But if we advance a day, and you're able to actually advance your days one by one if you wish, notice if I click one day ahead, now, notice I've got two little dots here. There's the moon, there's the sun, there's the moon. Notice that the moon is now not exactly in line with the sun. And therefore, advance another day. Notice in that case, when viewed from the Earth, you would see a little sliver of light on the right side, which we see right here. That's a waxing crescent phase. Notice how they're oriented in the sky. The sun is a little bit ahead of the moon. So therefore, as I move my guy around here, the sun sets, my guy can still see the moon a little bit, and therefore, I would see this waxing crescent moon in my sky. Now notice earlier in the day I would probably not see the waxing crescent moon. Why? Because there's too much light. Too much light from the sun. I wouldn't see the small amount of reflected light from the moon. But as the sun sets, now I should be able to see that waxing crescent moon very briefly because of course I continue to rotate here and that moon phase sets on me as well. So the waxing crescent moon phase, as we learned from the lunar phase dial, is only visible for a couple of hours in the late evening. Okay, let me take it back to new moon phase and bring my guy back around here. Now you're going to be asked a question in the lab quiz about the position of the moon and the sun on successive days or how, that sort of thing. So here's where this daily increment comes in handy. Because right now I don't see the moon because it's essentially lined up with the sun. If you change it by day, you know, it's still noontime. It's noontime the next day. Noontime the next day, the sun is still high in my southern sky, right on the meridian. However, notice that the moon is not. It's a little bit east of my meridian. Well, why? Because the moon is in orbit around the Earth. In fact, it moves about 1/30th of the way around the Earth each day, because it takes 30 days approximately for the moon to go one full orbit around. So therefore, every day, I'm still at noontime, but my moon keeps on changing its position. It's lagging the sun more and more each day because of its own orbit. And therefore, notice that it takes about 7 days to go from new moon to first quarter moon, in which the orientation now, remember it's still noontime, the sun is still high in my sky, but the moon is no longer lined up with the sun, which it had been a new moon. Now it is just rising on my eastern horizon. Okay, so that's how you use the lunar phase simulator. And again, I encourage you to go through all those background pages. They're very important in you understanding this material.